Hey YouTube, Savon Draws here. Today we're going to be going over some informal art news, and this week we actually have quite a bit to look forward to. So for one, we have potential Procreate Dreams updates coming up. We have Callipeg celebrating 5 years and coming to more platforms. We have potential updates for Canva and Affinity apps if you use those. We also have things to look forward to for Nomad Sculpt if you're into 3D. So let's just jump straight into it. And guys, also, if you have missed it, we actually had some small updates for Toon Squid and a fairly medium-sized update for Clip Studio that you can check back on my channel. Before we get into it, if you'd like to discuss any of these updates or just speak to people from the community, you can join my Discord. You can also send in your art animations or 3D to get featured on the channel. So today we're actually going to start off with our updates for Callipeg. Now, for those of you who don't know, Callipeg is a raster-based animation app for the iPad, and it's pretty good. I used to use it for a while, and it actually has some really good features in there for real traditional animators that like drawing all of their frames. Callipeg is now coming to Mac and Windows, even though they're in early development, and it's already available for free in beta on Android, if you didn't catch the video on that. Now, they're also celebrating 5 years, so they're hosting a competition where the theme is 5, and you can participate in it through April. You can check out their video to see the details. And basically, if you do well in the competition, they will give you a lifetime app for Callipeg on the Android. So make sure to join that competition if you guys have any interest, and we will look forward to the desktop release. Next up, we have the Canva Create 2025 event coming up on April 10th. There aren't any details on this so far from what I can tell, but this is interesting to me just because, of course, Canva is a great app for creating designs on any device really, and it's very approachable for everyone. Also, what interests me even a little bit more about this is the partnership that they announced with Affinity last year at Canva Create 2024, actually. And if you don't know anything about Affinity, they're basically a suite of apps that have three apps very similar to Adobe apps, basically alternatives that kind of work a little bit better in some ways and have most features that Adobe has in their apps. Affinity basically has alternatives for Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, and Adobe InDesign, which is something that's very good for graphic designers. Their apps are called Affinity Publisher, Affinity Photo, and Affinity Designer. What's really cool about their apps is even though they don't have like the AI capabilities of Adobe, they're much cheaper. They have a single price that you can buy these apps for, and they work across Mac, Windows, and iPad. And the iPad has a full version of the application, like it's a full desktop application that works the same. And what's also nice about this is you can just open all three apps within each other. Like if I'm in Affinity Photo, which is basically Adobe Photoshop's alternative, I can open up my Adobe Illustrator tools, which is really Affinity Designer tools, in Affinity Photo. And that just makes it work so much better without having to export things back and forth between different programs to get your intended result. So I really want to see some updates on Affinity, and I would love to see if Affinity and Canva could even like fuse their tools somehow the way Affinity has done with all their apps. That would be so dope to see. Or if Affinity makes a new program, like I'm very into animation on this channel, so I would love to see them do something like that. So yeah, if you've never checked out Affinity, you might want to check them out. They have a 3-month free trial on any hardware that you want to use it on, and you can really get a feel for the program. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. They even have a purchase option where you can buy all three apps together for all three different systems, or you can just buy each app separately. And they're not all too expensive, especially not for iPad. I own all of these on iPad, and I've tried them all out on the computer at the very least. If you purchase the 165 version, they also have cloud saves. The one thing that you should note is that if you buy a license for Affinity version 2, you won't get a license for Affinity version 3. They rarely update to a new version. They've been on version 2 for quite a few years, I believe 3 or 4 years since I've bought into them. But that's just something that I want you to know so you don't end up making a purchase that you don't want. Moving on, we'll focus on Procreate, which is having a event with InMotion Playgrounds, which is basically, from what I can tell, it's an event company that has animation-focused panels, and Procreate will be joining them. Now, Procreate, from what I can tell, has also joined them on stage before in previous years, maybe for 1 or 2 years. But since it's an animation-focused event, I figure we're probably going to see some more on Procreate Dreams, as they did promise us a big update, which I've covered in previous videos. So this event is coming on April 15th, so that's something you guys should look forward to. If you're looking for any updates for Procreate Dreams, just don't get your fingers crossed, as they said that Procreate Dreams updates are not coming before Procreate updates, and we are yet to get our Procreate updates. The one thing that does give me hope for this event is that Procreate is also advertising the event themselves. And on top of that, it's on a stage, and we know that Procreate really likes to announce their new features or new apps on a stage. Finally, we'll move on to Nomad Sculpt for anyone who's into 3D or any 2D artist that wants an easy gateway into 3D. Nomad is definitely the app you should try. You will need a tutorial, but after a while it will just click. It's not too hard. I've actually been using it for a while now and trying to create my own 3D characters. Now I'm gonna show my first sculpt, and don't make fun of me too much, but we have Sonic at home right here. This was my first sculpt. I've been working with Nomad for about 2 months, and I come from a 2D background, but it actually hasn't been too hard for me. I've been improving well as I use 3D on and off. But anyway, Nomad has been confirmed to be coming to Mac and PC for quite a while. They have a solo developer that has said they're going to focus on the PC version since about February. But if you guys want to, as a bonus, you can actually use Nomad on the PC right now through the web. Now, you won't be able to save or export. Actually, you can save, you just can't export. That the web version will automatically save your work, as it saved my work. But you can just try Nomad for free, mess around with it, and learn how to use the program. See if you'd like to purchase on iPad too. It's not too expensive. The web app is pen pressure sensitive, and it will also actually work on your iPad. So this is a good way to try it out as well on the iPad. I used it on my touchscreen Microsoft Surface computer, and everything worked seamlessly, like I was working in the iPad app. In fact, I might say I even enjoyed it a little bit more on the PC. Yeah, you just go to this web app that I'm gonna drop into the description, and you can have fun experimenting with the app. That's about it for today's art news. Remember guys, join my Discord, and if you like the video, like and subscribe. I appreciate it. See you guys soon.
Their apps are called Adobe. Their apps are called open all three apps within each other. Like if I'm in Adobe Photoshop, I can, like if I'm in Affinity Photo, which is